Gospel according to St. Luke, the 4th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command the stone to become a loaf of bread." Jesus answered him, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone." Then the devil led him up and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And the devil said to him, "To you I will give their glory and all this authority, for it has been given over to me, and I will give it to anyone I please. If you then will worship me, it will all be yours." Jesus answered him, "It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then the devil took him to Jerusalem, placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to protect you, and on their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone." Jesus answered him, "It is said, do not put the Lord your God to the test." When the devil had finished every test, he departed from him until an opportune time. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. So today marks that marvelous holiday that celebrates love. I suspect that a number of you sitting in front of me were willing to go to some extent to demonstrate your love for someone else. I suspect that some of your tables are adorned with flowers. I suspect that some of you also are desperately praying at this very moment that Wegmans maybe has a bunch or two available still. Maybe some of you bought chocolates for a loved one, a spouse, a significant other, your children, maybe even a coworker. I had to admit, I was really touched on Friday when I saw Amy Trishon's Facebook post of the flowers she got from the kids who brought them to her for being the best lunch lady ever. Expressions of love for someone who cares for others so well. Or maybe you sent a card to somebody. Maybe your parents. Or a friend you haven't seen in a while who lives somewhere else. Maybe you sent something to your brother or your sister. Regardless, I suspect that this is a day that you went or are going to go out of your way to let someone know they are loved by you, and that you will also be showered with affection and love from someone else. But for others, this day is a reminder that love has faded, or that it never happened. It is a harsh day if you're widowed, or single, or childless. Everybody else seems to have all of those wonders of love surrounding them. You know, Hallmark even makes a card for that. It's the Valentine's Day Stinks collection, and it is real. But to those of you who are without flowers on the table, and to those of you who have lavish celebrations planned, you are all loved. Each and every one of you. Extravagant. Unconditional. Lavishly. Truly. And that is the good news of this day. That we are all loved. And no matter how much money we spend on niceties, or how detailed and time-consuming was our planning and plotting for the perfect day, it is nothing, nothing compared to what God has in Jesus Christ done for you. God gave everything ultimate price for us, and the foreshadowing of Christ's passion is found in the text that is read for today. And Jesus was baptized, and immediately he was thrown into the wilderness by the Holy Spirit to be tempted by Satan. And he was so hungry after 40 days of fasting that Satan said, "Come on, just one stone into a loaf of bread. How much can it hurt?" But Jesus refused and trusted that God would provide for his needs. He was tempted with all of the kingdoms of the world. "Oh," Satan said, "these are mine to give if you just but worship me." But Jesus refused to worship anything or anyone but God alone. He was then tempted, "Fling yourself off this temple. God will send angels to catch you." But he refused to play games with God's power and might. You know, God could have chosen any number of ways to demonstrate the divine love that is for us. God could have eradicated evil, stayed up in the heavenly thrones, and just poof, made it all go away, staying distant from us. God could have breathed a spirit of perfection on each and every one of us, and then not needed to bother with us ever again. God could have done whatever it is that God could have done, but God chose to come close to us, to dwell with us, to be intimate with us in the person of Jesus. God chose to become one of us in the Christ. God chose to enter our reality and to walk with us and die for us so that we would never, ever, ever be separated from the love of God. And so to me, these verses, yes, this odd temptation story is the beginning of a love story. Because as Jesus goes out from the wilderness, he will be questioned for allowing his disciples to eat on the Sabbath when they are hungry. But Jesus, knowing hunger, can point to the fact that the law is a gift. It isn't meant to bind us, but to free us and give us life. And in a different wilderness, Jesus feeds those who are hungry and demonstrates the power of God to feed not one lone man in the wilderness, but thousands with just a few loaves and a few fish. And then gathered with his disciples at a last meal, he lifts bread and cup and offers himself as the bread of heaven and cup of salvation, a final gift of love for them and for us. As Jesus goes out from that wilderness, he's tempted time and time again to associate with the rich and the powerful, to network and claim seats of power at the head of the table. And time again, Jesus responds that power is not in the amassing of status and wealth, but in being a servant. Jesus demonstrates power by eating with tax collectors and sinners. Jesus demonstrates power by riding into Jerusalem on a donkey, by holding up a widow's mite as exemplary giving. And at his trial, he refuses to claim the title of king from Pilate and remains silent in the face of Herod. In his final act of love, he looks over the city of Jerusalem from the perspective of the cross. His eye was not trained on the riches and the power of this world, but on his subjects, the poor, the widow, the childless, the lonely. As a final act of love, he spoke to power that his kingdom was not of this world, and he gave to those who surrounded him, to those who abandoned him, and to those who betrayed him, a promise of hope in a power that is found in resurrection. His act as king was to forgive those who executed him and the undeserving sinners on either side of him. not call on God to save himself, but to save others from the evils of this world, from the demons that possess them, from the powers that possess them. His acts of love were found in raising the dead, in healing the sick, touching the leper, and forgiving the unforgivable. Jesus' power was not for himself, but for the powerless and the lonely, the oppressed, and the hopeless. Jesus' authority extended to children and widows, rich young men and blind beggars. And Jesus' power calls each and every one of us to place our trust in the love of a God who's created a world of abundance that is meant to be shared. Jesus' entire ministry was one of love, defying Satan's commands to use his authority to save himself. And as Jesus hung from that cross, one final time he was counting, "Save yourself. Come down off that cross." But as his ultimate act, he allowed himself to die for our sakes, so that as he died with and for us, suffered with and for us, lived with and for us, we would know the saving love of the resurrection to eternal life. Today's the day to celebrate love. And if you bought one of those heart-shaped boxes of candy, or if you've made dinner reservations, or if you're going to call someone, or if you've made plans with a friend who you know is lonely, I applaud you. Christ loved the world so that we would love others. And to celebrate that you have loved ones in your life, that is a gift that is indeed meant to be celebrated. These are wonderful reflections of the love that's been showered on us from God, who created each and every one of us to love and be loved. And he came to us, giving himself as the ultimate example of what sacrificial love is. You are loved. There is no doubt. So go.